So today's topic of discussion will be the effective stress and the capillarity portion. And we have already discussed some portion of effective stress, and two cases have already been discussed. And now we'll be starting with the third case here in this effective stress concept. So see here, this is the soil mass which is having the groundwater table at this level, and due to the capillary action, water rises to the, let's say, the ground surface. If it is the ground surface, so water rises up to the, by the capillary action. So understand here one thing for this point of time, that the capillary action is something where the water is held in tension, because we'll be discussing the capillarity concept in detail in the later section of this class. But understand here that this pore water pressure, which is this point or at this point or at this point, this is due to the capillary water pressure. And the, for this height, let's say this height, this is small height, the water which has to be risen up is very much small. The height to be risen up is very much small. But at this say height, this height, the water has to take much more force. It has to apply much more force to hold the water in tension. And similarly, when we go up to this level, it will be taking much more capillary tension, will be in much more value, in much more magnitude, and in a negative term. So when we talk about this A section, we will be discussing this 1-1 section, this 2-2 section, this 3-3 section, and then this an intermediate section wherein the capillarity is there. So the total stress at this point A is 0. At the pore water pressure will be minus, this is very important here, minus Z1 into gamma W, because the water is held in tension. It is not the usual way as the groundwater table is there. So here it is negative sign. Then the effective stress, you already know, that is equal to total stress minus the pore water pressure. So this comes out to be Z1 into gamma W. So understand here one thing, that the effective stress has some magnitude, some value, Z1 into gamma W. And you know here that the total stress value, it is 0. But this pore water pressure, which is due to the capillary, so capillary has done what thing? Capillary has increased the effective stress. So, and this effective stress in turn increases the shear strength and affects different properties of the soil, different engineering properties of the soil. Now see here, this at section 2-2, wherein the groundwater table level is there, the pore water pressure will be 0, because if we apply a piezometer here, there will be no rise in the water level, and the total stress will be Z1 into gamma saturated, because the soil mass above this 2-2 section till this 1-1 section is saturated with the help of capillarity. So understand here one thing more, that this gamma saturated could be gamma also. If let's say the capillary does not saturate the soil completely, so in that case it will be the bulk situation. So in that time, in that case, it will be Z1 into gamma, symbol gamma, that is the bulk one. So the effective stress is simply total stress minus pore water pressure, that is Z1 into gamma saturated. When we talk about this bottom layer, this 3-3 layer, here the entire soil mass will be exerting the total stress. So that we took Z1 plus Z2 into gamma saturated. Then pore water pressure is due to the groundwater table level. Understand here one more important thing, that the this capillary water will not be exerting any pore water pressure here at this level, at this 3-3 section. This capillary water is relevant for the section between 1 and 2, between these two sections. So when we talk about the effective stress, this is total stress minus the pore water pressure. So when we subtract it, we get this and this one value. So minus, it will be, it will, here it will be minus value, minus Z2 gamma W, total stress minus the pore water pressure. Okay, and at section 4-4, this intermediate section, what will happen here? You have to see this important point here, that let us say that this height from top is x, So we are analyzing at a distance of x from the ground surface, from the level ground surface. So the total stress here is x into gamma saturated, because the soil is saturated. If the saturation value is given to be lesser, so you will be taking the bulk situation. You will take the gamma as simply gamma bulk, whatever is given in you in the question. The pore water will be what? Negative 1. Why? Because for this region, this entire one is z1, and for this region, this portion that we are considering, that is z1 minus x portion, for this the water is in capillary tension. So the capillary tension, therefore we are taking it into minus sign. If the pore water pressure was there, and that was due to groundwater table, so it was in hydrostatic compression as usual. So here u is equal to minus z1 minus x into gamma w, and the effective stress will be total stress minus the pore water pressure. So understand here that I told you already in the very first thing here that at section 1-1 the pore water pressure due to the capillarity mobilized the effective stress. So the effective stress value was increased. So effect of capillarity, this is very important here. Effect of capillarity in soil mass is same as that of surcharge, as it helps in increasing the effective stresses in it. Now we are taking the another case number 4, where the soil mass is with surcharge and water table is at ground level. So understand here, water table it has at ground level. So this is one point. When the surcharge is there, we would be applying it gradually, or we would be applying it instantly, like just at that moment only. So when we talk about this instantly, we will be discussing few points. What happens at t is equal to 0, that at that moment on at which the surcharge has been applied, and at another time interval, that is t is equal to time t. So what happens? So when we talk about this gradual case, see here, in this case when the water table is at ground level, so when the surcharge is applied gradually, what happens? The entire surcharge is taken up by the soil solids, which results in increase of effective stress in the soil. So the very important thing here, it is the entire surcharge, that is the value q something, is taken up by the soil solids when we talk about the gradual application of the surcharge. But when we take the second case, where in the instant one, when the water table is at ground level and the surcharge is applied instantly, at that time the entire surcharge is carried by the water present in the soil mass. So you already know that soil is there. Soil contains what? The soil solids, and in between there is water, and this water, when the surcharge is applied here instantly, so in that, at that moment the water takes up the entire surcharge, it does not transfer it to the soil solids instantly. So in this case here, so the very first when we apply the surcharge instantly, soil the water which is contained in the soil, it will take up the entire load, but slowly it will try to dissipate and transfer the load, transfer the surcharge to the soil solids that we will be looking on. So see here, the entire surcharge is carried by the water present in the soil mass, that results in increase of the pore water pressure. When the pore water is increased, so it will be dissipated out, so it will be moved out of water, out from the voids of the soil mass, along with the subsequent transfer of surcharge. We will be seeing this subsequent transfer of surcharge over the soil mass. We will be seeing this, how the transfer of surcharge is there over the soil mass. When the entire pore water pressure is dissipated out, surcharge is being carried by the soil solids in the soil mass. So if the entire, like when we talked about the gradual one, the entire soils, entire surcharge was taken up by the soil solids. But when we talk about the instant one, the very first thing will be taken up by the water, but gradually it will be transferred to the soil solids, to the soil grains. So in this instant case, what happens? The first is the water which will take up the entire load, then the load will be taken up by the soil solids. So let us see here, when it is applied gradually, we are seeing it the gradual case, first thing. So this is the soil mass here of height z, and this is the section 1-1, section 2-2. So understand here, when the load is applied here, the total stress at this point will be q, we have taken this air, and then pore water pressure is nothing but 0, because if we apply the piezometer here, so what will happen? There will be no rise in the water level, so pore water pressure is 0 here. So the effective stress will be equal to total stress minus the pore water pressure, that is Q. Now understand, at this section 2-2, at the bottom section, the entire soil weight, that is above this section, that is above this 2-2 section, and the surcharge will be acting now. So at this, it will be Q, the total stress Q, and Z into gamma saturated, because the soil mass is completely saturated due to the groundwater table level, that is at the section 1-1. So the here it will be Q plus Z gamma saturated. So we plotted this point here, and this is uniform. So this will gradually, from this 1-1 to the 2-2 section, the due to this, as the height increases or the depth goes on increasing, as the depth goes on increasing, the value will be constantly increasing here. So, but when we talk about this pore water pressure, what will be the pore water pressure at this section? It will be due to the water which is present in this entire soil mass, that is Z, that is the height Z, and the unit weight of water, that is gamma W in kilonewton per meter cube, let us say. Now when we subtract this, we get this value sigma dash. So here we know that at section 1-1 its value is Q, and at section 2-2 its value is Q plus Z into gamma dash, that is gamma submerged. So this is the case of gradual one. Now when we talk about this another case, the instant one, and also at time t is equal to 0. So understand here what happens, that at the very instant, what happens? Entire mass is taken by the pore water pressure. So initially all the weight, all the surcharge is taken by the pore water pressure. So at the very instant, what happens? Pore water pressure is some value Q, that is the total stress value. Now we talk about this sigma dash, that will be equal to 0, and at the section 2-2, at this section, what will happen? The total stress will be equal to the surcharge applied, that is this one value, and the another thing, that is the pore water pressure, that will be equal to the Q, this entire Q, and the Z into gamma W, this Z height and the entire water in this soil mass. So here it will be Z into gamma dash, the effective stress value. So you subtract this value and you get this effective stress value. So this is at time t, but what happens slowly this load, which was entirely this surcharge, which was entirely transferred to the soil water, will now be getting transferred to the soil solids with time. So when we talk about this instant one, and at time t is equal to, let us say, t, at some time, when some time has passed, so what happens there? The pore water pressure will try to reduce, and it has reduced, like some amount of stress has been transferred to the soil solids now. So this is the amount of stress that has been transferred to the soil solids. So the pore water pressure will, which was initially Q, it will be getting decreased here. So at this section 1-1, what happens here? Total stress is equal to Q, as you already know. This pore water pressure, you already know that some of the stress has been transferred, and this effective stress will be equal to sigma minus U, that is equal to delta sigma dash. Now at section 2-2, that is at the bottom, see here what happens. This will be equal to Q plus Z into gamma saturated, that is the total stress. Now pore water pressure, what happens here? This is the Q minus delta sigma dash. So this is the portion which has been transferred to the soil solids, plus Z into gamma W, that is the water which is present in the soil mass. When we subtract it, we get the effective stress, total stress minus the pore water pressure. So when we talk about some instant time, this delta sigma dash plays an important role. When we talk about the partially saturated soil mass, so understand here, when we talk about this partial saturation, so saturation is not equal to 1, it is something less than 1. When saturation is less than 1, so understand here, that the value, this means that there is air also and there is water also in the voids. So there are two things in the voids. It is not entirely water. So when the soil is partially saturated, then along with the water, see here in this, air is also present in the voids of the soil. Hence, the total stress at any point consists of the effective stress, the pore water pressure and the pore air pressure. So the new thing, in the previous case we were discussing that effective stress was equal to the total stress minus the pore water pressure. Simple, this thing was there. But now, as we are talking about the partially saturated soil mass, we will be also taking the air which is present in the voids, which is exerting some amount of pressure in the soil. So we will be representing it by UA and the pore water pressure by UW. So there is this chi is a factor which represents the fraction of a unit cross sectional area of the soil occupied by the water. So we can say that chi is nothing but AW by the total area. So this AW we studied in the previous lecture, that A, total area, comprises of the area of water and the area of contact. So the area of contact was very much less, so we tend to be 0, and this A was almost equal to AW. So what happens when chi is equal to 0, that is a dry soil, and then when chi is equal to 1, it is a saturated soil mass. So this is the important thing here. When we are considering this partially saturated soil mass, we have to take into consideration the pore air pressure also along with the pore water pressure. Now taking one numerical here, see, a soil profile at bottom of the valley comprises of 2 meter of sand overlying 10 meter of clay. So there is a sand above, and below this thing is 10 meters of a clay layer. The clay layer in itself rests over a highly permeable weathered sandstone. Okay, so there is a highly permeable weathered sandstone. So it is highly permeable. We will be discussing how this will be taking into giving some important aspect here. The unit weight of the sand above the ground water table is 16 kilonewton per meter cube. So we will be seeing this, how this happens. Next, understand here that the water table is 1 meter below the ground level. So let us say this, if this is the sand layer of 2 meters, so the water table is at this much, at this one here, okay, at 1 meter below. We will be seeing this in the diagram. Now see, unit weight of the sand below the water table is 20 kilonewton per meter cube, and the unit weight of the clay below the water table is 22 kilonewton per meter cube. So the different values for calculating the stresses are given to you in terms of the unit weight. If the water table in the weathered sandstone is under artesian pressure corresponding to a standpipe level of 5 meter, this portion is very important here. If the water table in the weathered sandstone is under artesian pressure means when if some tube well is placed in there, or the water is taken out, then the water comes out to say some height h, and this height here is 5 meters above the ground level. Find the total pressure, effective stress and the pore water pressure at the bottom of the clay layer and the top of the weathered sandstone. So we will be seeing the two sections and we will be plotting the graph accordingly, plotting the variation of the total stress or the this pore water pressure and the effective stress. So understand here that what was given in the question. So here it is a sand layer which is 2 meters thick and it is above a clay layer. This clay layer is 10 meters in thickness. Now understand here that there is a weathered sandstone. If this is a weathered sandstone and it is highly permeable, so what will happen in due course of time, a large amount of water due to rain or some other factors would have been placed up here, would have been come up here. So now this, when we apply a piezometer here, we notice that the water level rises up to 5 meter above the ground level. So let's say this is the ground level. So the water level rises to 5 meters above the ground level. So this is the height here. Now the groundwater table was told that it was 1 meter here, 1 meter below. So this is the groundwater table level. Okay. Now you have to find out at this, at the bottom of the clay layer and at the top of the, at the bottom of the clay layer this and at the top of the sandstone layer. Now we are taking this two just above the point, just above this section, we will be taking a point that is the C1 layer, and just below we will be taking that as the C2 layer. Now considering this, we will be taking the different stresses which are being exerted there. Now see, at the C1 section and at C2 section, we will be taking these two points. C1 is what? The bottom of the clay layer, at the bottom of the clay layer. And this C2 is what? Top of sandstone layer. So understand, this sandstone layer is under some artesian pressure. So if this is some, under artesian pressure, so the what are the changes here that we will be seeing, because that artesian pressure will be applying some pore water pressure that will be see there. Now see here, the total stress will be due to the sand layer and due to the clay layer. And see here, at C1 section, this section, it will be due to this clay layer and due to this sand layer. So this gamma is some there, this gamma 1 is there, this gamma 2 is there, this gamma 3 is there. So these are the different gamma values that we will be considering. So for the sand layer, the uppermost portion, that is 1 meter, is dry, and then the next below that dry portion is the gamma saturated value because of the groundwater table level. Now for the clay layer, it is then entirely saturated because it is entirely under the groundwater table zone. So gamma saturated into the 10 meters of the clay layer. Now we put on the values here, the gamma D value, the gamma saturated value of the sand, and gamma saturated value of the clay, that is 22. So it comes out to be 256 kilonewton per meter square. When we talk about the pore water pressure, see here, the total distance is this 10 and then this 11, that is the groundwater table level here. So see here, this is the 11 into gamma W, that is the water which is exerting some amount of pressure there. So 11 into 9.81 kilonewton per meter cube, and this was in meters, so it comes out to be this much value. When you talk about this effective stress, you already know that is equal to the total stress minus the pore water pressure. So we get this value. But when we talk about this C2 section, that is at the bottom of the, that is at the top of the sandstone layer, what happens there? The total stress will be same, because it is just below. See here, it is just below this C2 section. See here, this C2 section here, it is just below. So the entire soil mass is the same. There is no such difference when we are talking about the total stress value. But when we talk about the pore water pressure, what happens here? The water is under some pressure here. What amount of pressure? One thing is there, that is the 11 gamma W, that was already present because of the groundwater table, but there was an artesian pressure equivalent to 5 meter above the ground level. So we take this 5 meters and then this 1 meter. So the entire distance, this one will also be considered. This one is 11 here and then this one is 6. So the entire 11 plus 6, 17 meters will be considered. So that that comes out to be 166.7 kilonewton per meter square, and effective stress value is nothing but total stress minus the pore water pressure. So in this case, it comes out to be 89.3. So understand here, very important thing. Let us now plot the values and get the graph here. So understand, just at this section, if you are talking just above, so the total stress value is the same. So there was no problem as such whatsoever we are dealing here. But when you talk about this U, pore water pressure, what happens? That at just above this section. It was 107.9 value, but due to artesian pressure, the pore water pressure was increased and it went up to, shot up to 166.7. So there was a change of 58.86. The value you noted was 166.7 and the change was 58.86. So when we subtract this, we get the effective stress. So understand here what happens, that due to this pore water pressure, the effective stress got reduced here, due to the artesian pressure, this by the same amount by which the pore water pressure was initially increased. And here the effective stress came out to be 89.3 at just below this section. So this was changed by the amount of 58.86. That was the change in the pore water pressure level. So these are very important things that we understood here. Now going on for the capillarity, we already studied one case in the previous section, in the previous wherein we considered that the water was under capillary tension. Now see here, the capillary water is the water which is lifted by the surface tension above the free groundwater surface level and is held in suspension. When we talk about held in suspension, it means it has been held up. Like let's say if there is some well and the bucket is there, so when it is held up, so it is being pulled up. So the rope is in tension. Similarly here also, when the soil solids which are here, and these soil solids, what happened? This is the void, so the water tends to go up and these soil solids will be trying to pull up the water, These are the soil solids and this is the portion where it is the void, and the water will be pulled up due to the capillarity action of the voids. The water fills the voids of soil continuously up to a certain distance above the groundwater table level. Now the water in capillary tubes hangs in a state of tension that I already told you here, and is supported from the sides that we saw in this diagram. See here, it is supported from the sides, that is this solid will be trying to hold up the water, and from the sides of the tube at the edge of the meniscus. So the capillary action that you see in a simple capillary tube in your physics or chemistry lab, that action is shown in the soil solids also, in the soil voids also. So understand here, last point in this slide, that rise of the water in capillary tube takes place up to an extent surface tension force equals the weight of the water in the capillary tube. Because understand, if that surface tension force, let's say the water rises up here and this is the surface tension force, so it will be trying to lift up the water, and there is this weight of the water which is acting downward. So how does this surface tension force balances the water? Water weight which acts in downward direction, we will be seeing in the next section, in the next lecture that we will be covering. So thank you, and we will be covering the capillarity portion in the next topic.